you consider what nature is impartially, and without the particular prejudices and particular sets of spectacles which these shallow men had inherited from persons principally interested in such non-human subjects as logic and algebra, what you will see is this. In the whole vast dome of living nature, there reigns an open violence, a kind of prescriptive fury which arms all the creatures to their common doom. As soon as you leave the inanimate kingdom, you find the decree of violent death inscribed on the very frontiers of life. You feel it already in the vegetable kingdom. From the great catalpa to the humblest herb, how many plants die and how many are killed? But from the moment you enter the animal kingdom, this law is suddenly in the most dreadful evidence. A power of violence at once hidden and palpable has in each species appointed a certain number of animals to devour the others. Thus, there are insects of prey, birds of prey, fishes of prey, quadrupeds of prey. There is no instant of time when one creature is not being devoured by another. Over all these numerous races of animals, man is placed, and his destructive hand spares nothing that lives. He kills to obtain food, and he kills to clothe himself. He kills to adorn himself, he kills in order to attack, and he kills to defend himself. He kills to instruct himself, and he kills to amuse himself. He kills to kill. Proud and terrible king, he wants everything, and nothing resists him.